brand new movie, he leaves behind a checkered past for a big career as a public speaker. We have so much in common. Romany Malco's here. Mr. Malco, sir, how are you?
Man, I am doing great. Good to see you, Mr. Rubin. How you doing?
Really, really good to see you. And I tell you what, I feel we talked about the idea of doing this movie for some time. You put your heart and soul into this. For those rare who are unfamiliar, talk to us about TJ, about Tijuana Jackson, and the character kind of blew up online, and now here comes the movie.
Exactly. I really just made the character because there's like a lot of young people in America who would never, ever consider, going to a self-help seminar or reading a self-empowerment book. And so I want to figure out a way to like expose them to it without them going, oh man, this is corny, tuning me out. I created this fictitious character who was over the top, ex-convict, gets out of prison, wants to be a motivational speaker. And people just fell in love with them. The New York Times did a full page write up on them, and the kids just gravitated to it. And the next thing you know, they were telling me to make a movie. I didn't even know what a crowdfunding campaign was when they told me, start a crowdfunding campaign, we'll finance your film.
And were the origins of this because somewhere along the line, a motivational speaker had gotten through to you in some way?
And you know what? No, honestly, the origins of this is that I used to really laugh at motivational speakers. I thought it was kind of hilarious. And then I also started seeing the correlation between like motivational speakers that were considered gurus and people that I grew up with in the neighborhood where it was like the best, worst advice you would ever get. And something about the irony of like someone who's pretty broken, accomplished in no way whatsoever, giving you life advice was just hilarious. And I thought, and I live for irony. So I thought it was a no-brainer for me.
All right, we're going to look at a clip. Regina Hall, who everybody has a crush on, plays the probation officer that you have a crush on.
Yes.
All right, here is Tijuana Jackson. Look at this.
Have you coordinated one job interview yet?
Interview for what, Cheryl? I'm going to build my motivational company from the flow up till it blow up and get my dough up.
How you going to eat? How you going to pay bills? How you gonna stay off them blocks?
By being the world's coldest life coach.
You better find that bridge, because you ain't about to be idle on
my watch. I'm gonna beat somebody idle. You can count on that.
And you can count on me taking your back to jail if you stay unemployed. I mean that.
Okay, hey, Lil Lee, what's old boy's name? Went on the internet, the entrepreneur, and got rich.
Never know. Evan Spiegel?
No, the one that be with all the Asian guys.
Oh, I know. Mark Zuckerberg?
Go on Mark Zuckerberg's page and tell him that Cheryl said that he's unemployed. Let me know what he said.
No, don't tell him that. I ain't say that. You the one on probation.
All right. It really plays. This whole crowdfunding thing, was there, and I don't know how this necessarily works, was there a thought, okay, I've raised $100, I've raised $10,000, where you thought, oh my gosh, I'm really going to get the budget to make this movie?
You know, honestly, you don't. Crowdfunding campaigns are interesting because you never really ask for what you want. You always ask for 50% of what you're asking, and a successfully funded crowdfunding campaign will be funded between 200 and 1,000% of asking. And so, honestly, you know, we're promoting our film right now and trying to get people to do pre-sales on pre-orders and all of that. And it's very similar in the sense that you would think that with all the support that, like, you know, the support would just come flooding in. You kind of really work for every single contribution with a crowdfunding campaign, and there's never a moment of you being completely confident.
All right. The movie's been completed, about to be released. You must feel confident about this, though. Tijuana Jackson, Purpose Over Prison. Folks can see it in a variety of places, right?
Absolutely. Listen, you can see Tijuana Jackson, Purpose Over Prison on iTunes. You can see it on Apple TV. You can see it on Vudu. You can see it on Google Play if you have a Droid. You can see it on Fandango Now. There's a huge list of places.
Terrific. Hey, it's really nice to see you. Very stylish headphones, by the way. Again, the movie available in a variety of places, it just said.